What's up, YouTube? This is a tutorial on how to use the Quant Chain. We're going to go through some of the basic settings and how to get started. Everything we're going to be discussing, or everything I'm going to be mentioning about this device here, which is the Quant Chain UV-K58, will also apply to the older version without the 8 at the end. This is factory, so I have not done anything to it. In fact, I have got two of them. This is the one that I was messing around with. This one here is untouched. I literally just took it off the box. So this is what it's going to look like from the factory.
Welcome, channel mode 1-3.
Now, I'm going to point the obvious here, which is when you're going to purchase this device, just make sure that you buy a device for your region. And that's because they come preloaded with certain weather channels. And certain settings that are useful for your region. Now, right off the bat, the first thing I've noticed about this is that when comparing it to the Baofeng, with the Baofeng, you pick it up and you just,
1-4,
it's ready to go. Like, you can literally just put in the frequency and you're good to go. It's not the case here. It took me just a little bit to figure things out. When you try and change something, you're basically changing the channel. So you like, and this right off the bat, it's not easy to see how to change the frequency. So the first thing I'm going to show you is how to enter the frequency. And the key to the key to controlling this device is in this key here, this one here. The F key stands for function. It works in combination with other keys. So let's say now I want to change the frequency. I'll press F, P.
Frequency mode.
There you go. So now I can put, or I can punch in the frequency that I needed. The second thing I want to show you is how to save a frequency. Now, and also for the sake of demonstration, I'm going to punch in a frequency from this device here. So I just press exit. Okay. So we're going to use this one here, 456650. So let's just punch this one in.
456650.
Okay. So now that we punched it, let's just do a quick test. There you go. So you can see here, orange light means it's transmitting, and then green light here means it's receiving, and then vice versa. Okay. So now, this is how you enter frequency. The second thing, as I said, I'm going to show you is how to save it. So once you've entered your frequency, if you want to save it, you click this button here, which is the M.
Menu.
And then you scroll down to, I believe, item number 13. There you go. So memory channel 13. So I'm going to click M.
Memory channel.
Okay. So every time you see the word or the letter CH before a number, it means that channel is occupied. So what you want to do is you want to keep scrolling up or down. Well, there's 200 channels in this. Find one that's not occupied. So there you go.
So
from 18, there you go.
Confirm.
That's it. Now you can see the letter CH. That means it has a channel loaded into it. The third thing I want to show you is how to delete a channel. And the way you do it is you want to go to menu and then scroll down. I believe it's item number 50 something, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, it's exactly as I thought. Item number 50. So as you can see, this is the channel we saved.
Delete channel.
It will say delete channel, and you click
confirm,
and then you click yes.
Confirm.
And then now it's deleted. Now if I search,
cancel.
If I search, let me go
channel
to channel mode.
One.
The way you go from channel mode is, again, you click the F and then number 3. Now that I'm in channel mode,
one.
As you can
one.
See,
seven.
There's no it goes from 17 to 1. So that means no more 18. So as you can see, that this is the key here. The F key is the key to controlling or to actually get started with this device. It's slightly different and also slightly annoying, to be honest, because this it just means that there's an extra step every time you want to do something. Now, with that out of the way, let's actually talk about some of the other functions that are in the keypad. So starting with number one, we'll try and cover as many as possible. Starting with number one. Number one is band. And what that means is when you are on frequency mode, so if I click F3, if this, the band basically just moves you from, let's say, the air band, which is typically between 108 to 136. You click again, it takes you to the marine band. Click again, amateur band. Basically, it just helps you cycle through them. Let's do a quick demo. There you go, 490, 55, 108. Now, this is the air band. 145, this is the marine band. 245, and so on. So this is to cycle through the bands. A and B, so this one is simple. It just moves you from, because this is a dual band radio, so it just moves you from between the two channels. You can see the arrows here. If I click F2, it takes me to the other one. And then if I click it again, it takes me up again. Three, this one we already covered. This is to move between the saved or memory channels and frequency mode, which is basically the manual mode. Fourth one here is number four. It says FC. Basically, it stands for fast copy. So it's just a way to copy frequency when you have devices that support it. Not necessarily the same brand, but devices that support this feature. Basically, a quick way to copy frequency between a group of handheld radio users. Number five, this one here is simple. It says NOAA, which is basically the weather channel. The thing to note about this one is that once you're in it, you have to deliberately exit in order for you to be able to use anything else. So if I try to go to band, it won't work. If I try to go to frequency, it won't work. I have to deliberately exit so that I can go back to where I was. Number six, this is a one that you want to pay attention to. Simply what it is, it says HML. It's basically the output, the power output. So this is responsible for the range. So if it's on H, obviously it's high, M is medium, and L is low. Currently on both channels, it says H, which is high. I would assume that the reason why they have this feature is to help save battery. Number seven is Vox. This is an interesting one. If you press F7, all it does, you can see that the letter Vox, the letters V-O-X, basically stands for voice operated transmission. What that means is, this is why I have this radio here. Instead of pressing the push to talk, if you have this feature turned on, which I have right now, every time the microphone detects that something is coming through it, it will automatically transmit. Notice how I do it. Now, it's difficult for me to actually speak and show you on camera, so I'm just going to tap on it to simulate someone speaking. Notice this light here. Okay, so that's because I have it on a different. Let me just change the channel. So I'll change it to 4.
4, 5, 6, 6, 5, 0.
There you go. Now that it's matching, I'll just tap it to simulate someone speaking. There you go. So A very cool feature. I quite like this one. Number eight is says R. It's basically reverse, which just switches the receiver with transmission, with transmitting and then receiving with, or transmitting with receiving. Number nine is says call. This is basically emergency call. This feature here is, although it says emergency call, so in theory it should help you, but if you don't, if you have not done some homework to know what is the emergency channel, because there are places and countries and states that will have dedicated emergency channels, it becomes useless. So in theory, what it does, it can, it will continuously transmit a signal. I want you to think of it like an old school fire drill, if you will, right? It just sends out an alert to send or to let someone know that you are in an emergency situation. And then this one here says scan. So obviously scan if
scanning begin.
It just scans while you're in the frequency mode or even on channel mode, it can still scan. And then last but not least, the one that says zero, which is obviously have to exit the scan. And then FM. There you go. So these are the keypads. Now, a few more things. So the last few things I will leave you with is the, you'll notice sometimes that, and again, this is one of the annoying things about this device. It's a fantastic device, don't get me wrong, but it just, there's always seemed to be an extra step. You'll notice that now, let's say I'm on this frequency here and it's silent. There's nothing coming through. So sometimes what you need to do is you need to click this button here to start actually receiving. So you'll see the flash is pointing towards the this channel here. I have to click. And it says RX. So that's how you know that it's transmitting. So it's a little bit strange, a little bit annoying, but it is what it is. The last one I will leave you with is how to connect it to Chirp. It's basically a quick setting. All you need to do is you want to turn it off and then hold down the push to talk and then turn it on, turn the knob on, and you will see the emergency light turns on. The screen stays off. This means that it's ready to connect to a computer. So that's been it. A really, really nice device. I quite like it. I like the design. I like the way it looks. It's fantastic. In the future, I'm thinking I'm going to start doing range test, because my collection of handheld radios is growing. I've ordered one more. It's on the way. It's a Rattel RX470. So stay tuned for that. I hope you find this video useful. If you have any questions, please let me know. I will also leave a link, or I will leave a link in the description for a detailed manual on how to use the device. Obviously, we can't cover all the features, we can't cover all the settings, but in that manual, you will find everything you're looking for. And I'm talking about everything, the hidden stuff, the menu, the settings, every single little detail. That's been it. I hope, again, you found this video useful. If you did like it, hit the thumbs up, leave a comment if you have any questions, and I'll catch you in the next video.